Gracias, Teresa, por ese excelente discurso. Yo me llamo
Thank you,
Estefania
Teresa.
Arboleda. Buenos días para todos los presentes.
Estefania, I would like to say hello to all of you.
Conozco muy de cerca el desaliento y
I know very well what uncertainty and discouragement is of having no security, no stability. In Colombia, we had a period of violence, and my family and I had to be displaced because of the violence, and we had to go to Antioquia. And we leave Antioquia and go to Barranquilla, a city, a dangerous city. So we were in a zone where that was very dangerous, and we had to build our house ourselves with wood, and that neighborhood was called Loma Roja. That means very dangerous. So when I was a little girl, I had to work very early to help my family because we had very few resources. So I had to start to work to help my father, my parents, my brothers and sisters. I felt despair. My father really was hoping that he would be able to provide for us stability and a safe place, but unfortunately he was not able to do that, and I had to go through very difficult moments. And I remember how sad it is to live those circumstances where you have nothing, where you feel total despair, because you know that this is your destiny, and I had trouble accepting this destiny. I had no opportunities, I was poor, and for me it was difficult to accept this situation. But later, after a few days, my father died. He was sad when he died because he was not able to provide a decent home for us, and he was not able to do that. And then, after his death, I had to work to support my mother, my brothers and sisters. So I had to work when I was 11 or 12 years old, and I had a very heavy burden of responsibility on my shoulders. But I heard about an organization in my neighborhood called Football with Heart. And I heard that it was able, possible to overcome this lack of opportunities I was stuck with. So I was able, through this association, to overcome the situation. But I'm happy myself, but I'm thinking about all those young people in my country that are still in the situation I was in before. And this is thanks to this organization that I was able to study. I could change my vision of my life. It changed my life forever. Thanks to Football with Heart, I was able to obtain a grant to study at the university. At the start, I was just a little girl being displaced. I never dreamt I could go to university, and I never thought I could go to the university and become a professional. I was studying psychology, and thanks to that, I was able to understand life in general and the life of those boys and girls in my situation, and I wanted to help them. I wanted really to contribute to change their lives. Psychology for that helped me a lot, and this is why it is so important to give one opportunity to those boys and girls from my country the way I had myself. And as a coach of football, I had the opportunity of giving back to those children what I received, that love for life, that happiness, that joy. I want to give them that, but what is the most important for them is that they can believe their dreams can come true. When I was a little girl, I went to this association, Football with Heart. I remember my coach. You know, I heard that organization had come to the neighborhood, and I told him, I heard that they were not only accepting boys, but they were accepting girls. And I was so deeply touched by that. And I wanted to go. And I went there, and I told the professor that I'm coming here because I want to be someone in my life. And I always remember that moment. I was a tiny little girl then, but that changed my life. So sometimes you see something, a tiny little thing that happens, and you don't know that that little thing will change your life. So I think that ourselves, we can do a tiny little thing that will change the life of someone else. So in Colombia, the young people have a lot of enthusiasm, they have a lot of energy. They are ready to do something to change the reality of society, of the families. But all this we can't do alone. We need the cooperation of all of you here present. And I would like to take advantage of this particular moment because there are very high personalities here, ministers and so on. So I think you can really work in favor of world peace, and we need your support. And it is a key moment to continue in this direction because we need policies from the state that would include women, young people into sport. And this will help a lot to change the world. Thanks for your attention.
Merci.
Thank you both. That was so amazing.